Hey guys, welcome back to Android Studio developer course. And in this tutorial, our main focus is how can we be able to work with XML file. As I told you guys, XML allows us to edit or show what we intend the user to see in our application. So for example, as you can see, we have main activity.xml. It's the one that contains this hello world and the button one, and it's what is being shown when we run our application in our emulator. Remember guys, we made a tutorial on how we can be able to create emulator and run our first application in that emulator, and this was our first application. So what we are going to do in this tutorial, we are going to change some elements on the screen using activity main XML, and then see how they reflect or how they show once we run it on the AVD or emulator. So to get started, click on your activity main, check to see you have the design checked, the split of the code. I like using the split, it helps you to split between the code and the design. Then you can minimize the console area, and the first thing that you are going to do is to remove our hello world and the button here. I'll start by explaining what is constraint layout. Constraint layout allows us to constrain view with another view. For example, I can have a button here, and I'm going to set this button width as 0, and the height I'm going to give it its lab content, and I'm going to close it here. Then this button will always be at a point of 0, 0 unless I constrain it. So I'm going to say this button, I want it to start of parent. Remember, when I say the button should start at the start of parent, it's showing that the button is going to start at the end of the parent, that is on the left side. And then I want this button to end at the right side. So I'm going to say parent. And then I want this button to be positioned on top. So I'm going to have top of parent, and then I'm going to have it also positioned at the bottom of parent, so that button gets stretched, and finally it's in the middle. I can give my button a text, and I can say it's button one. If I want to add another button below it, let's give this button an ID, and then I'm going to have button one. Let's say I want to have another button below it, and then I'm going to have my button, and then I'm going to give it 0, and here I'm going to have lab content, and then I'm going to start of parent, and I'm going to end of parent. But now I'm going to have it top bottom of button one. I can give it some top margin of 2, and then I'm going to name it text button. Button 2. As you can see, we have. Let me go back to our design. So we have button 1 and button 2. These two buttons are aligned vertically. You also might want to align your button horizontally, but before we align them horizontally, let's first learn and see what we have. So we have our button 1 and button 2. These buttons are stretching up to the end of our parent. So we might need to add some margin to prevent them from going to the parent. So I'm going to go back here and say I want my button to have a margin of 10, and I also want to remove this one and also give this one a margin of 10. And then I'm going to run my application once again. We have 10, this should be 10 deep. Let's see. There we are. So someone might want to know, how can we align these buttons horizontally? Remember, I'm also going to do another tutorial explaining the different layout in Android. We can use constraint, we can use layout, linear layout, we can use relative layout. We have different types of layout. So in this case, I'm just going to small basics of constraint layouts. Stay tuned or subscribe so that you can know when I do a more detailed tutorial explaining constraint layout, a full tutorial of itself. So I'm going to show you guys how I can be able to align these two buttons horizontally. So I can decide to use a linear layout. Or first I align them the way they are. So I'm going to have 0, and this one is 0. But this one I'm going to have, instead of end to the parent, first let me give this one an ID, and I'm going to have button 2. So this one is going to end start of button 2. And then this one is going to start end of button 1. And I'm going to remove this top button. And I'm going to have it top of parent. And I'm going to have it bottom of parent. This one I'm going to have it removed the end, and I'm going to have it top of palette. So it's, as you can see guys, I have both buttons now aligned horizontally. So as you can see, constraint layout is allowing me to align each element next to one another. Okay, it has a lot of work. So there is another layout called linear layout. It's much simpler when you want to align layout below each other's, or even horizontally, which I'm going to do in my other tutorial of explaining different layout in Android. So guys, stay tuned so that you can continue learning more. So in this course, I just wanted to show you guys how can be able to play with XML file and display different items to the user. I'm also going to add a big ribbon here, and I'm going to say text view, lab content. Let me show you how we can use colors. So I'm going to start of parent, I'm going to end of parent, and then I'm going to have top of parent. And then I'm going to have button top of button 1. Then I'm going to have its text here, and the text shall be my first application. There we are guys. And then I'm going to give it a color here. We can decide to make it black. And then the size is small, so I can add size and say it's 24. Let's see in our design, and let's learn this application and see. Boom, we have my first app of button 1, we have button 2. Remember guys, this one is called toolbar. So we are going to learn more about it in another series tutorial. So there we are. We have now been able to achieve our objective for this tutorial, that was to play with different elements in the XML file and display them in our AVD or emulator. So in our next tutorial, what you are going to learn is the click event or the interaction between the user interface and the backend. The backend is the Java file behind this one. So that when I click this button, something happens, we can toast a message or we can move to a new activity. When I click this one, we can do something different. We can change this word or even display a toast message. So guys, stay tuned and subscribe for more tutorials.